Hey y'all, so we are, I look a little crazy. I've been through a lot these last couple, I'm not even gonna say days, weeks. Like, my weeks have been so busy. So much has been going on, from dance to moving and to going to Africa. We are in the airport.
We must now. I can't wait for her to come to my home country.
Traveling during COVID has obviously been complicated. It's like,
it's not the word. Complicated is not the word.
It's the worst. Like, the airport is already an extreme sport by itself, but like with coronavirus, like, there's a whole bunch of forms. If you're traveling out the country, forms in other language that you may not even know what the form is saying. You gotta use translate, Google Translate to figure it out. But we got through it. I feel like I'm about to embark on a spiritual journey right now. I've never been on a flight this long. I've never been on this side of the world, period. Like, I've only been to fucking Miami and Mexico. But I'm headed to the motherland, y'all.
Chick sit on my, I attack that. Choose up, Lil John, I'm finna pack him. When it comes to my chick, I'm straight acting.
So we are on our second flight out of Atlanta for our layover. Y'all, this plane is huge.
The plane is like our complimentary
headsets. She's been shouting the whole day. She does not have to speak, know how to speak at monotone. I thought I was loud. Mui's loud.
She's lying.
Mui started to get crampy. Like, her body started to hurt on the second flight.
Yeah.
I mean, on the first flight. So we'll see how. We'll see. We'll tell you guys things that we've done to like get through the 8 hours. So the first flight was easy. For me, I slept the whole first flight, which I'm actually pissed off. I wanted to stay up so I could sleep on this flight, because it's the longest one. And this one's going from Atlanta to Paris. And then from Paris, we go to Bamako.
Hello.
Who's this?
It's like that.
It's like this.
Like
God.
Hey.
Hold up.
Wait.
You fire, girl, bother your feelings. What's the problem? You got a boyfriend, but do you love him like how you say?
Deny it, girl. Your body's so exotic. You hypnotize.
I've been hitting baby girl for 7 days. You should link right now and make it 8. What would I do if you wasn't my baby?
So one thing that is definitely new to me about coronavirus, like traveling with coronavirus, is that you have to pack snacks, especially on long flights, or else you're gonna starve. Like, don't come to the airport thinking, oh, I can just, I'm gonna get snacks. Like, no. So a lot of stuff is closed. So like, pack a million snacks. Just make sure everything's under 3 ounces. Cheers.
We're in the airport in Paris.
Your body's so exotic.
I've been hitting baby girl for 7 days.
You should link right now and make it 8. What would I do if you?
So basically, we just time travel. Excuse me, I've never been in like a time difference like this, except for Mexico. But literally, when we left Atlanta, it was nighttime, like 5 o'clock, and the sun was going down. And I'm looking out the window and the fucking sun is up. And we're a day ahead. So while everybody's sleeping in New York, what time is it in New York?
2 a.m.
2 a.m.? It's 2 a.m. in Atlanta and in New York.
3 a.m.
3 a.m. in Atlanta and in New York. And here, it's 9 a.m. I'm baffled.
Probably the flight was 7 hours. We're about 5 hours into the flight. We have 2 hours left. Me and Mui pretty much slept most of the flight. I'm in the bathroom right now. I took my contacts off to sleep to give them a rest, so I have to put my contacts back on. So we are down to the last 2 hours of the final flight from France to Bamako, and y'all thought I could do it. I'm losing it. Like, my back hurts. I feel like I can't breathe. I've been stuck in the same position for hours. It's really this last flight that took so much out of me. I was fine until now. My eye hurts like a bitch. I literally had to just get up and stand up and walk to the bathroom. And I'm probably gonna stand up in front of this bathroom for like a few hours. I mean, not hours, like just stand up, because I can't sit down anymore right now. It's driving me crazy.
I can now hold back my burning temptation. I can't lie, defy. I be dubbing my old bitch now, but you baited.
Take a sip of my gin and juice.
She a big buddy, Benz, cool, drop top Mercedes.
All the thighs wanna party, but the honeys wanna
hold up. Here I go. I be in a business, I sell. If I know. Two bitches, one pimp, tryna rock me to sleep and drive the boat. Thought it all was a dream, yeah, I was sure. There was a bitch in between me and a hoe. What she know is I can breach her. No, I don't know her name, but damn.
What can you do about shorty?
Take her from the spot to my block where that Henny calls 40.
I felt the vibes when she parted. Hit the trees from the back, she threw that ass back on me.
So we're here at Mui's mom's house.
For today.
My contacts are about to shrivel up and fall out of my eyes. We had some problems in the airport, so we didn't get to. And then we'll probably wind down.
You can take this one. It's easier for you. Or are you gonna learn?
I'm gonna learn.
Okay, good. Learn. It's good.
Where am I eating?
I
check
it.
I check
it. It's made with cassava. It's topped off with plantains, sweet plantains.
Right.
Fried fish.
Right.
And then tomato, green pepper, onion, cucumber.
This is my first time having cassava.
What kind of fish is this?
Hell no, they don't do tilapia here.
No, tilapia is man-made. It's too small to be a snapper.
It's not red enough to be a snapper.
It's in my stomach, that's what it is. Why don't you guys buy some kind from the airport?
Yeah, usually you can, but she...
My dad said that when he bought his SIM card from the airport, it was blocked. So he don't know, people are like reselling old SIM cards in new packages.
Yeah.
That's how they mean it. So he'd rather go into like a store where you know it's always new and fresh.
Oh! Why don't y'all
just
pack up y'all stuff and come to my house? These bitches is really in Africa.
Yeah,
but I do
look
bigger.
The lower body! Hey, YouTube! Twerk.
Alright y'all, so today is the next day. We are walking to the airport from the
picking
parking lot.
Picking up Tamia and Alex.
I haven't been vlogging the first day because there's something wrong with my eye. Like a day before I came here, I got a rip in my contacts. And I guess it must have been like causing friction inside of my eye. And it made a slit and I guess some bacteria got in it. So I'm developing a sty on my eye. But I guess because just like the sand in the air and just, it's getting worse. It's just getting worse. So now I can't even wear my contacts. So I can't even see where I am. I can't see anyone. Yeah, but we're waiting for it to me and Alex.
Hi, honey. Oh my God, y'all made it. Hi. Hi, beautiful. I missed y'all.
Jesus Christ.
Hose her down!
That booty dude.
Ew.
Make sure you get that bug, Alex.
The bug?
Make sure you get that bug.
Well, here we got three perk 40s. We about to get trippy. Nah, these are malaria pills. I had to take three in the middle of the trip. and then another 3 when we got back. I never took the second dosage. I'm just not into medicine like that, and I didn't get malaria, but do that at your own risk. We got ours in Mali, but you can also get them from your doctor at home. I think your best friend want me. Talking both bitches, both freaks, both drunk, both horny. She bringing bitches back for me. Like the bitch at 9, I was in the trees, guts 9:40. I knew if you wasn't my baby. My baby. I cannot hold back my burning temptation. I these fights. I'm yelling my old bitch now, but you baby. I have never. If you wasn't my baby, ooh, yeah, yeah. I cannot hold back my burning temptation. I he's fine. I'm dubbing my old bitch now, but you baby. Take a sip of my gin and juice. She a drink body bass, full drop top Mercedes. Thighs wanna party, but the honey's wanna vibe. Yeah, I love more than one at a time. Guess I it was me and you on the same day, same vibe. And I was so accustomed to rock star life. Take your bitch, get it right.
I cannot hold back my burning temptation. I can't lie, these fights. I be dubbing my old bitch now, but you baited.
Take a sip of my gin and juice. Mm-hmm.
She a big buddy Benz, cool drop top Mercedes.
All the thighs wanna party, but the honeys wanna
hold up. Hold up, here I go.
Never change. Hold up, oh, shit, big, body big. In front of me, she taking up both lanes. Not a star, but she was born for the life. Camera girl, you look better in the light. Matter of fact, you look better with a fight. I fucked a few Mary hoes, cause they was
mine. What I do if you wasn't my baby?
My baby.
I cannot hold back my burning temptation.
I lie, these fights.
I be dubbing my old bitch now, but you baby.
Take a sip of my gin and juice.
She a big body Benz, cool drop top Mercedes.
All the thighs wanna party, but the honeys wanna vibe.
Can I drag her up here?
You come all the way to the motherland to act like this?
My God, I don't want to deal with this. Movie's coming back soon, so go get back in your spot.
Look at her face.
Her plug, because I don't know where my bag is. Move.
It's crack.
Ooh. You really took my wig off there.
Are y'all gonna turn the light off in your room?
I am done. I'm done.
If there's two words for please, one is for strangers, one is for.
So I'm about to shower. I'm not showing my whole face right now because my eye is still messed up. But it's a little frustrating because if you guys don't know, I wear contacts because my vision is really bad. I usually wear glasses, but conveniently they were broken. So I can't really see anything. It is kind of like ruining the experience for me a little bit. It's really humbling to like be 1,000 miles away from home and like something's wrong with you and you can't really do anything to fix it. But I am trying to do my best and still have a good time. I don't have like anything to treat it really, but I'm about to shower. It's my first time doing this. And basically there's two buckets, one with regular water, one with hot water. And what you're supposed to do is add the regular water in the hot water till it feels like usable.
This is the bathroom. Everything's like together, which is cool. My toes are not done. But yeah, like the sink, the shower, everything's in one, which is dope.
I cannot hold back my burning temptation.
I these fights.
I be dubbing my old bitch now, but you baited.
Take a sip of my gin and juice.
She a big body Benz, cool drop top Mercedes.
All the thighs want to party, but the honey's one of us.
Say hi to our YouTube.
Huh?
Say hi to our YouTube.
Where's your YouTube?
Right there. She doesn't want to talk to you guys.
Mind your business. Yeah, make sure you get in between the toes.
How can I hold back my burning temptation?
I
can't lie, these fires.
I be dubbing my old bitch now, but you baited.
Took a sip of my gin and juice. Mm-hmm.
She a big body Benz coupe, drop top Mercedes.
All the thighs wanna party, but the honeys wanna
hold up.
Here I go. I be in a pit, miss myself.
If I know.
Two bitches, one pair, tryna rock me to sleep and try to boat. Thought it all was a dream, yeah, I was sure. There was a bitch in between me and a hoe. What she know is I can breach her, no, I don't know her name, but damn.
What can you do about shorty?
Take her from the spot to my block where that Henny cost 40. I felt the vibes when she parted. Hit the trees from the back, she threw that ass back on me. I think your best friend want me. Talking both bitches, both freaks, both drunk, both horny. She bringing bitches back for me. Met the bitch at 9, I was in the trees, guts 940.
You wasn't my baby.
How can I hold back my burning temptation?
I
lie, these fires.
I be dubbing my old bitch now, but you baited.
Took a sip of my gin and juice.
She a big body Benz coupe, drop top
Mercedes. The thighs wanna party, but the honeys wanna
vibe. What I do if you wasn't my baby?
Ooh. Yeah, yeah.
How can I hold back my burning temptation?
I
lie. Fire.
I be dubbing my old bitch now, but you baited.
Took a sip of my gin and juice.
She a big body Benz coupe, drop top Mercedes.
Thighs wanna party, but the honeys wanna vibe. Yeah, I love more than one at a time. Guess I it was me and you all the same, that same vibe. And I was so accustomed to rock star life. Take your bitch, get it wet like it rain. On God, some things never change. Hold up, hoop, she did, body boots. In front of me, she taking up both lanes. Not a star, but she was born for the life. Yeah, my girl, you look better in the light. Matter of fact, you look better with a vibe. I fucked a few Mary hoes cause they was
my life. What I do if you wasn't my baby?
My baby.
How can I hold back my burning temptation?
I
lie, these fires.
I be dubbing my old bitch now, but you baited.
Took a sip of my gin and juice.
She a big body Benz coupe, drop top Mercedes.
All the thighs wanna party, but the honeys wanna vibe.
What would I do if you wasn't my baby?
Ooh. Yeah, yeah.
How can I hold back my burning temptation?
I
lie, these fires.
I be dubbing my old bitch now, but you baited.
Took a sip of my gin and juice.
She a big body Benz coupe, drop top Mercedes.
All the thighs wanna party, but the honeys wanna vibe.
What would I do if you wasn't my baby?
Ooh. Yeah, yeah, oh.
How can I hold back my burning temptation?
I
lie, these fires.
I be dubbing my old bitch now, but you baited.
You live in here?
Yeah.
This the new Pending Location house. We moving in. You can't bring New Yorkers nowhere.
Bitch!
How you know I didn't want another sip?
There's some down here for you.
No, shut up. You didn't even care.
This is playing hops.
You didn't even care.
First of all, you drank most of this.
No, I did.
Yes, you did.
No, I did. I
mean, you took like
you're
a couple sips and you put it all the way down.
You
are
trifling.
Shut up,
shut up. She's just ruthless. Like you're primitive, like a caveman.
Yeah, we
all
run.
Run.
You put this in your
pocket.
I'm just
gonna put my bag in front of your feet.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Now I gotta take a picture. I love
you. He looks like he's about to start selling them bags.
First of all, look at this.
Thank you.
Sala never got out of it. Never going to function in Mogu. If they can attack us, Raymane.
Y'all, we are looking for a giraffe. Tamia asked to see a giraffe. So we got these, she got these people looking for a damn giraffe. I'll let you guys know what we find.
You gotta do what you gotta do.
There's a drone in the sky. You guys probably can't see it, but it's like right there somewhere. And it's searching for the giraffe because it's so big and these weeds are so tall. First of all, never seen that in real life.
What, a giraffe?
No, the witch. No, that pot on the stone stove. Where's the chickens? Mui? Somebody's stealing your watermelon. What?
Yeah, it's like an apple.
Yeah.
Why aren't you guys feeling like
maybe in a week?
I don't know. What are you spilling?
Everything.
You probably don't squeeze when you grab it.
We're going to change in the little hut. Let me see some ass, Alex. What happened?
I said, "Ooh, is that a bar?
I like the space." Oh, the
ball.
Yes,
this way.
It's about to spend all my Molly money.
Hold up, here I go. I'll be in a pit, myself. If I know. Two bitches, one pair, tryna rock me to sleep and try to boat. Thought it all was a dream, yeah, I was sure. There was a bitch in between me and a hoe. What she know is I can breach her, no, I don't know her name, but damn. What can you do about shorty? Take her from the spot to my block where the Henny calls 40. I felt the vibes when she parted. Hit the trees from the back, she do that ass back on me. I think your best friend want me. Talking both bitches, both freaks, both drunk, both horny. She bringing bitches back for me. Met the bitch at 9, I was in the trees, guts 940. You wasn't my baby.
My baby.
I cannot hold back my burning temptation.
I
lie. These fires.
I'm loving my old bitch now, but you baby.
You think the donkeys will enjoy this? I
don't really like
that.
Ça va?
Ça va?
So, that's all we've learned. We're coming to the. I'll just fucking see that?
Oh my god.
Every time I look down, I get so queasy. Anyways.
Why? It's really not that far.
Bitch.
Yeah. Can we borrow some of the drinks?
We are coming to the end of our trip. We've learned a lot of French and a lot of bambara, bambara.
By a lot, we've learned about 2-3 phrases.
No, I think we know more than that.
I know awo.
Awo means yes.
I know ai.
What's ai?
No.
Ai is no.
I know. Ankiliki. I think that's gaucherie.
Goosh is left. Oh. I know nam. That's like a response. If someone called, like if somebody say, Tamia, she says nam.
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 And then I know.
We know, know bonjour, bonsoir, bonui.
Aun tu benga subuli.
What is that?
I'm going to the market.
Oh yeah, subu is the market. So we've learned a lot of bambara. Bambara is what they speak in Mali. And then French, of course, that's the second language here. Learning the currency, that's anywhere you go.
You don't really have to learn it here because we have speaking with people that know what they do.
Yeah.
It's so much easier that way because I just give Mumi all my money. She could be selling for me. I don't know.
Stuff here is like really cheap, I'm going to say. But at the same time, it could get expensive. So if you're going to come for 2 weeks, I'm going to say, and you're
Masha.
Masha. Not bad. I'm going to say bring, and you're like paying for your own stay, I would bring like
$1,000. Oh, thank you. Masha, say hi to our vlog before you leave. Cool. Say hi to our vlog before you leave.
You know, vlog.
Mm-hmm.
Vlog.
This is Mui's cousin. We did the trip like not the glamorous way, which was, I feel like when you're going to like learn about a country, like it's best to be able to stay with the people, like if you want to go and learn about the country and like get a real experience. Because when you go and you just stay on the resort, you kind of just get tourist treatment. We did actually go to a resort. And we got that experience too, just to know what it's like. The resort was really cute. The traffic here is crazy. It is nothing short of Atlanta or New York City.
And they don't have street signs.
They don't have street signs.
They be rough riding.
Yeah. Here you gotta know where you're going.
You need a driver.
You need a driver. Because there's no street signs or anything. Getting sick in another country is not fun. I'm pretty sure my eyes swelled up so big, I had no peripheral vision. You can't just go to a doctor to get medicine or to be diagnosed.
It's different.
So if you know that you have any type of pre-existing conditions or anything like that, make sure you bring everything you need to be able to treat yourself, because y'all, if you wear like contacts or glasses, I'm gonna say don't even fucking bring the contacts, but you need to bring a pair of glasses because the dust here is so bad. Keeping touching your contacts and putting them in your eyes, like it's not like the dust, it's in the air. We also got sick here. That's how we know the hospitals are like not what they are in the US. It's not modern medicine at all.
They don't have the fancy looking hospital that you may be used to. The dust out here, it's like red dust, so you really don't want to be bringing anything that you want to stay a certain color or stay brand new, squeaky clean.
Then dressing here, like you have to basically just pretty modestly, like it's okay to like wear like certain stuff, but they like you're gonna get stared at anyways because they know you're not American. But it's a Muslim country, so like most places you go, you gotta be pretty much covered up, leggings, t-shirts, stuff like that. When you read the news, like hear the news and stuff, it makes it seem like it's impossible to go anywhere during quarantine, but that's not true. You just have to know what borders are open for you to go to, and then you just have to make sure you gather all the information of all the things that you need to go to that place. It's definitely a lot more complicated when traveling, like when we've been a couple places since everything happened in March. It was a little bit easier in March. I think we went to Miami. There wasn't all these papers that you had to fill out and COVID tests that you had to do. It wasn't all of that. But now there's like, we had to sign a form for every country we entered. So every layover, there was a form for that country that you had to sign. And every country wanted your COVID test.
Honestly, not as complicated when you're flying domestically. When you're flying out of the country, it's a lot more because not only are they checking your customs and they're doing the passport thing, but then they're also doing
coronavirus test on top of these other procedures they want you to go through. Which is-
and they ask you for a lot of personal information, and apparently, like, when you put your real information in those things, they just call you and harass you to get tested and to look out for a vaccine and stuff like that. All of that stuff is on top of, like, your regular vaccines, because we still had to get regular vaccines, which can get expensive whether or not you have insurance. We had to get yellow fever shots to come here, and it was like $350 per person.
And insurance doesn't really cover it because
it's not like you don't need it.
No, insurance doesn't cover it because it's limited in the US.
Oh yeah.
And it comes from parents, so they don't have but so many yellow fever vaccinations, and there's only a limited amount of places that actually do the vaccination. So they use that as a token to jack that price up. So it's originally what, $280? And then we had to pay the fee to the travel clinic on top of it, so it turned up to like almost $400.
See the world, because you never know when your last day is gonna be or when you're gonna be capable.
Okay, please don't be depressing.
It's very humbling. I'll never.
It's just rude. Oh, excuse me. I don't know how you called me.
Chick shit on my, I attack that. Choose up, Lil John, I'm finna pack him. When it comes to my chick, I'm straight.